Namaste. Hey, this is Trevor Seven, and I would like to introduce you to the PSI Science Lamp. It's trademarked by Conscious Monkey Technologies, and here's where I got it on the internet. And it's a little pricey, but I was shooting for something that would give us a legitimate means of testing psychokinesis, ESP, and telepathy if you had, you know, a sender and a receiver. Of course, I'm working alone here, so we're going to focus more on the psychokinesis and the,
no time for that now. The computer's starting.
Precognition, also known as clairvoyance. So, and first I just want to introduce you to this. This is just the outer cover. It's just kind of fancy. It's got the little Zener border thing on it to kind of make it look a little more appealing. And then this is basically a circuit board with these four outer lights, or the indicator lights. I mean, the principle is it changes red, blue, and green, and you're supposed to anticipate what color it's going to change to. And at the heart of this technology is this little random number generator. And it's a legitimate piece of equipment. I mean, you can use this. I mean, it's totally random. And it's, as a matter of fact, it's a little too random. Sometimes between changing from colors, sometimes it's 4 seconds and sometimes it's 20 seconds, you know. So, and when you're trying to do precognition and stuff, it's good to kind of get, you know, really relaxed and kind of get into a flow and a rhythm. And this little machine here doesn't really allow that to happen. This is a classic example of left brain designers building stuff for right brain practitioners. Yeah, we need to merge these two sciences. I mean, ideally, it would have a nice little blackout, you know, like maybe a 3-second blackout, and then give you a random color for 3 seconds, and then blackout, and then give you a random color for 3 seconds. You know, so you can kind of get into a rhythm and a flow, and that's not at all how this machine operates. But anyway, aside from all that, it is pretty useful, and I thought we'd put it to use. And it's my policy to never try to teach something that I cannot demonstrate. So I'm going to pop a couple demonstrations in here, both of psychokinesis, where I'm influencing the number generator, which I can do a pretty cool little thing with this gizmo, and then a precognition. And the precognition test is, it's more accurate. The larger number you use, the more accurate it becomes. You know, they have statistics that are legitimate once you get up to about the 60 range. So we're going to do a 60 color choice test, precognition test or exercise. And the way it works, this basically has a number generator, a random number generator, and the numbers are associated with the colors. And it's 1 is red, 2 is blue, 3 is green, 4 is yellow. And then you can use these two little toggle switches. I don't know if you can see those. But you can use those to get various different settings to where the number generator will use numbers 1 through 4 only, or numbers 1 and 2 only, or
1 and 16, or 1 through 128. You know, of course, the cycle repeats, you know, red, blue, green, yellow, red, blue, green, yellow, all the way up to 128.
So it's very random. and the point being, it's legitimate. I mean, it's a good way for me to test myself and you to have a way of doing it. And, you know, if you write your results down and stuff, you can get a legitimate test right here on this video. So, before I get started, like I said, I always like to try to demonstrate everything first. So I'm going to pop a little demonstration, and I'm going to spare you a whole, you know, 60 guesses on this thing. My average score, okay, here's the deal. If you get 15 is chance, you know, the odds are 1 in 4. Probability is 1 in 4. So if you get 15 out of 60, that's just chance. And if you get between 15 and 21, that's a pretty good chance, you know, that it's not just chance, that you are actually getting some precognition happening. And if you get over 21, you're psychic. And my average score, my lowest score was a 12, and it took me a while to get used to all this. You'll see what I mean by all this flashing that's going on. It took me a while to get used to it. My lowest score is a 12, my highest score is a 37, and my average, or the score I seem to hit the most, is about a 26, 27. So I didn't do anything really remarkable anyway, with 37 being my high score. But I did get 7 in a row, and I caught that on film. So I'm just going to take a little clip of me doing 10 tests and getting 7 in a row. I think I got 8 out of 10. I can't even remember now. It's on this camera. I haven't watched it yet, but in a row. And it's the same way with ESP. I can't, you know, doing the ESP cards, I can't speak because it snaps me out of my trance. So I struggle with trying to do it and saying red, you know, and it just, as soon as I start talking, it engages my left brain and just ruins my whole train of thought. So what I did was I got these lighters with the appropriate colors, and I just held them up. So
that's my red, and then, you know, and blue, and then green, and yellow. And
that's how I did it, you know, so I could demonstrate it. That's the only way I can demonstrate it. When I start speaking, I couldn't hit nothing, you know. I was getting less than 4 out of 10. So here's a little clip of me doing a little 10-second demonstration of precognition. And then following that, I will show you a demonstration of me messing with a random number generator. As I mentioned earlier, you can use this for psychokinesis or precognition or telepathy. And as much as I'd love to be levitating this machine, I can't do that. But I can seem to jam the circuit to where it won't select a number. And the longest cycle, just, you know, based on my observations, between choosing a color was 24. And that's very rare. I mean, typically it's around 12 or so. But I'm going to go 24 seconds. 3 times to show you that, you know, it's not choosing a primary color. And the technique I'm using is just, I'm kind of pounding it with white light, and I've kind of built this mental image of how the random number generator looks on the inside, all these ones and threes and fours and twos, you know, just bouncing around randomly back and forth between circuit to circuit. And I just imagine speeding them up faster and faster and faster and faster, so fast that they never get a chance to choose a number, you know. And I can also seem to be able to force a color onto it. However, I haven't got any of that on camera. But one time I got 5 blues out of 10, which based on my statistics is not normal. So anyway, I don't know what you were expecting for a psychokinesis demonstration, but I went with this one, jamming the circuit. So there you go, a full 324 second cycles without choosing a color. Okay, so there's the demonstration portion, little psychokinesis and precognition, or clairvoyance. And before I really kind of get into sharing the technique, which is very similar to my approach for ESP cards. So if you haven't seen that little trilogy, little three-part ESP cards series, you might check that out and help you. That'll help you before you do this test. But anyway, I wanted to show you couple things I didn't mention. One thing, it's got a little output here that attaches to your computer so you can do random number generator tests on yourself, and supposedly you can interact with them on their website using that plugged into your computer somehow. And but I'm going to turn this on so you can see the colors. It flashes. When you first turn it on, it does a little test thing. It goes red, blue, green, yellow, about that speed. And you'll notice it's kind of hard to tell between the green and the yellow. But if you look closely, there's a little touch of red in these primary bulbs whenever it's yellow. And whenever it's green, that little touch of red is not there. So that's how you can tell. And I'll dim the lights so you can see a little better. All right, so here we go. Red, blue, green, yellow. And all this jibber jabber, funky stuff you see going on in the middle is just the inner workings of the random number generator. And the price you pay for random number is random timing. I mean, you'll notice sometimes it takes, you know, 3 or 4 seconds to choose a color, and sometimes it takes 14 to 24 seconds to choose a color. So it's really hard to get into the flow of things. Which is, you know, you hear a lot of people talk about getting in the flow. Well, it does kind of help to have sort of a timing, a rhythm to it. So that's, you know, one setback to using this thing. But we do get, you know, trustworthy feedback from it. You know, it's truly random. So if you're guessing correctly, you are showing signs of precognition. But anyway, that's the gist of it. But basically the approach I take, and I've been working with this quite a bit, and the approach that I found that works the best is to relax the body as usual and empty the mind and everything. But you know, the problem is you have to see, you're trying to select the next color while you're looking at a color. Like now it's green, and it's hard to not think about green. It's like me saying don't think about a pink rabbit, and you know, and automatically you have a vision of a pink rabbit in your head, you know. So what I do is just kind of not focus so much on the primary colors. I just kind of look off to the side and kind of use peripheral vision and just relax when it changes the color. Like there, it just changed to green. I don't think about green. I just anticipate the next shade. It's yellow, and it is yellow. And just kind of, you know, do that. Don't focus on what color it's actually on. Remember, you're always empty and expecting the future, because it's just usually just a couple seconds before it changes whenever something pops into your mind. So that's kind of the approach I use. This is a pretty busy little sucker, and like I said, you know, all that little gosh garbly junk going on in the middle is just drives me nuts. And that's why I do it with this cover off. I also think it's easier to influence the inner workings of the circuitry whenever it doesn't have the cover on it. Just like doing telekinesis under glass is harder than doing it out in the open. So, but anyway, for the test, I put the fancy cover on it, and I kind of cropped it and moved it and did some adjustments, you know, kind of. Sometimes there were some of them that were like a 20-second wait, and I kind of adjusted the timing a little bit. I didn't change the outcome, but to make it a little more flowing. And then I also gave you a little scorecard, so if you're trying to keep track, that way you can have a little way to check it. And I'll also give the scores again at the end of the video. But that's the basics of it. And there's another way to doing precognition. We're going to do 60, because when you do more, the results are more accurate. So we're going to do 60 color change tests. And you can do this two ways. You can do it on the fly, which is how I recommend it. Or you can do it the textbook way, where you just write down all 60, red, blue, green, yellow, you know, 1 through 60, and try to guess them that far in advance, and then just check your score with the actual outcome. But like I said, I recommend kind of doing it on the fly. And if you're wanting to keep track, you know, you might want to record yourself or take notes. You know, you could just use the R, G, B, and Y, you know, instead of having to write out the words and stuff. But the less left brain activity you got going on, the better off you'll be. Probably the best way to get the most out of this would just be just to free flow it. You know, don't even keep score. Just try to get into the flow of anticipating the next color. So that's basically it. The old Psy lamp. And I'll run this all the way in its entirety. And like I said, I'll give you a tally of the scores at the end so you can, if those of you who are keeping track, can check your scores. All right. I wish you the best.